Les verbes avec l'auxiliaire être. So if you remember, in some cases, for what we call composed tenses, you will have to use whether avoir or être. So in most of the cases, you will have to use avoir. But then in some cases, you will have to use this auxiliaire être. Okay? And well, I've been doing some videos regarding this topic, but then I thought that maybe it might be useful to see, because there are many, many different techniques to remember the list of verbs that will require this être verb. And then here is one of them. And it's called Dr. A and Mrs. P. Van de Tramp. Okay, so it's a technique that apparently is used in, well, English-speaking countries. Okay, so we'll see that it can be quite useful. I'm not really sure if it's working for everyone, but still, it's one technique. Okay, so the idea is that you will, well, try to remember actually these or these names, and then, well, each letter will represent one verb that will require this auxiliaire être. Okay, so let's start now. And so if we take the whole thing here and then we take only the first letter here, it's D, and then D will be for the verb descendre. Okay, descendre. Then after that, R will be for rentrer. Okay, rentrer. Then M will be for mourir, mourir. R will be for revenir, revenir. Then we'll have S, and it will be for sortir, sortir. P, passer par. Okay, passer par. Then V, venir, okay, venir. After that, you will have A, and A is for aller, aller. N, naître, naître. Then you will have D, and D will be for devenir, devenir. E, entrer, entrer. Then R for retourner, retourner. T for tomber, tomber. R for rester, rester. Then A for arriver, arriver. M will be for monter, monter. And last but not least, P will be for partir, partir. Okay, so you have it. As I said, I'm not really sure if it works for everyone, but then it's one option, okay? Or then the other option will be, or would be, the classical list, and then you learn them by heart. I mean, that's one option. So let's see them one more time, okay? So the first one is descendre. After that, we'll have entrer. Then mourir. Revenir. Sortir. Passer par. Venir, aller, naître, devenir, entrer, retourner, tomber, rester, arriver, monter, partir. Les homographes. So don't be afraid, don't be scared. It's actually not that difficult. When we're talking about this homograph thing, we're talking about words that will be written almost the same way. Normally they should be written the same way, but in we'll see that we've got two cases that are a bit special, but then they are written almost the same way. But then according to the gender, so whether it's masculine or feminine, the meaning of the word will change. Okay, so we'll see the first one. The first one is un moral. Okay, un moral. And so you can see the meaning here in English, okay? And so if we see the feminine form, and I wanted to start with this one because, as I said, in most of the cases they will be written the same way, but in that case you've got this e at the end, which is silent, so you don't pronounce it. So clearly it is the same pronunciation for the two words, but then in that case it's feminine, une morale, okay? And here is the meaning in English, okay? So un moral, une morale. Okay, so let's see the second now. Un moule. Okay, and you've got here the meaning. Un moule. And the feminine form. Une moule. Alright. Une moule. Okay, keep in mind you pronounce them the same way, but then, as you can see, the meaning is different. Le physique. Le physique, and here is the meaning, and then la physique, la physique, and you've got here the meaning, okay? Le physique, la physique. Un poste, un poste, and here normally, so poste or position, we're talking about a job, okay? Un poste. Une poste, une poste, and here is the meaning. Un tour, un tour. Okay, so actually this word has quite many meanings, so it can be tour, tourner, turn, and other meanings as well, but then the good thing is that the feminine form une tour has only one translation, and it's here. It's our une tour. Okay, so un tour, une tour. And then un livre, une livre. Okay, so we're talking about the pound, so it can be the measurement for the weights, or then it can be as well une livre sterling, so if we're talking about the money, okay? Un mémoire, and then une mémoire. Un capital, un capital. So here we're talking about money. Une capitale. So you can see that we pronounce it the same way, but as we had previously, you've got to put this at the end. Okay. Un voile. Une voile, and here with the sail, we're talking about the part of the sailing boat. Is homophone, so it's actually quite interesting in that lesson. So we'll talk about words that you will write differently, but then phonetically you will pronounce them the same way, and of course they will have different meanings. Okay, so let's start now, and the first one is un air. Okay, we'll make this little link between the two, un air. Okay, and here you've got the translation in English, and then you've got une air. Okay, so you can see that you write it differently, but then clearly phonetically it's the same, une air, and this is the translation in English. Une amende, une amende, and that's what it means. And then, une amende. So here you can see that the only difference is here you've got a and here you've got a, okay? So, amende, amende, and the meaning is fine. We're talking here about the nice little gift you will get if you break the law. Une amende. Une encre. Une encre. And then feminine as well. Une encre. Okay, so you can see here that the only difference is a here and then a here. Okay, so une encre and une encre. It's the same. Un bar. Un bar. And then, une barre. Okay, so you can hear that it's exactly the same way to that you pronounce, but then you get R, R, and then E. Okay, une barre. Okay, so in that case, it's this adjective, bon, and the meaning is good in English. Okay, bon, all right. And here we've got substantive, un bon. Un bon. Un bout. Remember, final T not pronounced. Un bout. Une boue. Okay, so here the only difference between the two is here you get T at the end and here you get E at the end. Une boue. Un but. Un but. Une but. Une but. Un sang. Okay, remember this G here doesn't exist, so un sang. And then here we've got this sang. Quite useful because it means without, sans. And we've got a third one, sans, written like that, and it's 100. Okay, so un sans, sans, sans. Un champ. Un champ. Un champ. Un champ. So here it's quite tricky because if you look carefully, well, of course you pronounce them the same way because that's the topic of this video, but then masculine in both cases. So un champ, un champ. Un col. Un col. Une colle. Une colle. The lysomophone, because actually I was thinking about doing four videos concerning this topic. So remember, when we're talking about lysomophone, we're talking about all these words that we have in French that you will write differently, but then pronounce the same way. And of course, the meanings will be different. So that's the reason why it's quite important to take a few minutes to try to see them and try to avoid any mistakes. Okay? All right, so we'll start now. And the first one is un compte. Un compte. And here you will have the translation. Un compte. So exactly the same pronunciation, but then, of course, the meaning is different. Un compte. Un coup. And then un coup. Alright, so you can see that you get this final P here, but then you don't pronounce it. And last, un coup. Okay, remember, accent circonflexe, you don't pronounce it. Final T, same thing, you don't pronounce it. Okay, so un coup, and then un coup. The same pronunciation. Une cour. And then we've got the adjective cour. And after that, un cours. And then, un cours. All right, so you can see that here you get the feminine, une cour, then you get the adjective cours, un cours, un cours. Un cuir. And the verb cuire. Okay, so un cuir, and then cuir. Une date. Une date. So it's quite interesting because in English it's written the same way. Okay, so in that case we're talking about the fruit. So une date. Okay, and here une date. So 31 janvier, for instance. Une date. Okay. Une eau. And then the adjective eau. Okay, une eau, eau. Une fin. And then, une fin. Okay, so phonetically the same. Un fil. Une file. Okay, so don't try to, well, don't mix it with une fille, okay, because you get the double L, but in that case you get only one, so une file, okay, un fil, une file. Lait. Un lait. Okay, so the only difference is final thing here, de, you don't pronounce it, te, you don't pronounce it, so phonetically you only have this le. Une mer. Une mer. Un mer. Alright, so mer, mer, mer. Right, in both cases, here you've got the feminine form, and then here it's masculine. Of course, it could be feminine as well, because mère can be ladies as well. Les homophones, so remember, we write them differently, we pronounce them the same way, and they have different meanings. Okay, so that's the thing. It is the third video, so the next one will be the last one covering this topic. Okay, so let's start now. Un mètre, and so you will have the translation here. Un mètre, and then un mètre as well. Okay, so un mètre and un mètre, same pronunciation. Un mois, and then moi, me. Okay, so un mois and moi. Un mur. And the adjective mur. Okay, so un mur and mur. Un nez. Nez. Okay, so un nez and nez. Un nom. Nom. Un nom. Nom. Un pain. Un pain. Right? Un pain. Un pain. Un père. Une paire. Père. Okay, so in that case we're talking about the numbers, all right? So père. So here un père, une paire, père. Une patte. Une patte. Okay? Une patte, une patte, une paume, une pomme. Okay, so you can see that I pronounce them a little bit, well, a little bit differently, but then we'll be careful that in many, many cases people will pronounce them the same way, okay? Because in that case, normally it should be a bit lower, pomme, and then here more open, so pomme, okay? Une pause. Une pause. Okay, so une pause, une pause. Les homophones, so it's the fourth video covering this topic. Remember, les homophones, we're talking about words that are pronounced the same way but written differently, and of course the meaning is different. Okay, so we'll see 10 of them in this video. So let's start with the first one. Une peau. And here you have the meaning in English. Une peau. Un pot. Okay, so une peau, un pot. Un point. Un point. All right, so you can see that here the only difference is the final letter, okay, but then they are pronounced the same way and both of them are masculine. Un point, un point. Un port. Un port. Okay, exactly the same thing here. Only the last letter is different. You don't pronounce it, and then both of them are masculine. Un port. Un prêt. 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 Okay, so it's quite interesting here. So you've got un prêt written like that. So in that case, it's a substantive, so word, noun, and that's the meaning. Then you've got prêt like that, so final S, but then of course you don't pronounce it. And here, prêt, so the adjective. Okay. Une roue. Roue. Alright, so une roue, and then roue. Salle. Une salle. Okay, so even if you get the double L here, it will be still the same pronunciation as this one. So salle, une salle. So in that case, it's here, it's an adjective. Un seau. Un seau. Okay, so un seau, and then the same way, un seau. Sûr. Sûr. Okay, even if you've got this accent circonflexe, you don't pronounce it, so you get the same pronunciation, sûr and sûr. Une tente. Une tente. Okay, so it's exactly the same pronunciation, even if you get a here, here, and e here. Okay, and both of them are feminine. Une tente. Un toit. Toit. Okay, so in that case, we're talking about moi, toi, lui, elle, so we saw that a long time ago. Okay, and then both of them are pronounced like toi, un toi, toi. Le préfixe il, so il. When we're talking about préfixe, normally we're talking about, well, letters, a group of letters that you will put in front of existing words. And by adding these letters or group of letters, you will change the meaning or the original meaning of the word. Okay, and that will be the case with this prefix IL. Okay, so let's see. And so normally if we're talking about this IL prefix, then it will mean privé de sans. Okay, and this is actually what it means in English, so without or then, well, less. Okay, so that will be the meaning of this IL prefix. Let's see three examples. So the first one here, légitime, okay, so légitime. And then if you want to express, well, the without concept, then you will add this prefix IL at the beginning, and then after that you continue with your original word légitime, and now you get illégitime. Okay, illégitime, légitime, illégitime. Second example, lisible, okay, lisible, and then same idea. You just add this IL in front, and then you get illisible, illisible. And the last one, légal. Okay, légal, exactly the same concept. You just add this IL in front of légal and you get illégal. Okay, so of course you understood that we add this IL here because the original word is starting with L. Okay, so that's the reason why you will have this E and then L. All right, so légal, illégal. Le préfixe IM, okay? So when we're talking about prefix, we're talking about letters that you will add at the beginning of existing words, and by adding these letters, you will modify the meaning of the word, okay? So let's see now. And in this lesson, well, by adding this IM at the beginning of existing words, in most of the cases, they will start with P, okay? Just for information. By adding this IM, you will modify the meaning and it will mean privé de or sans. Okay, that is the result that you will get by adding this IM. Okay, so let's see now a few examples. The first one is père. Okay, so the meaning is even, and then I just put some numbers to make it clear that we're talking about numbers. So, 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay, so, père. And then if you want to express the without, so you will use this impair. Impair. So, you put IM, and then after that, the rest, impair. Okay. Pardonnable, pardonnable, same rule, same way of working, IM in front, impardonnable, impardonnable. Parfait, parfait, exactly the same, imparfait, imparfait. Pensable, pensable, and then it goes all the time the same way, impensable, impensable. Poli, poli, impoli. Impoli. Possible. Possible. Impossible. Impossible. Précis. Précis. Imprécis. So you can see that it's all the time the same technique, so you just add this IM in front, imprécis. Probable. Probable. Improbable. Improbable. Prudent. Prudent. Imprudent. Imprudent. Oublie le préfixe IN. Okay, so remember, when we're talking about préfixe, we just were talking about letters that you will put in front of existing words, and by adding these letters, you will modify the original meaning of the word. Okay? So in that case, this IN prefix will mean privé de or sans. Okay? Privé de sans. And this EN will be used when the original word is starting with a vowel or H plus une voyelle. Okay? So let's see a few examples now. And the first one is acceptable. Okay? Acceptable. You will have the translation here in English. And it's not that difficult in that case. And if you want to express this privé de or sans, okay, without or less, then you will add this EN as we saw first at the beginning of your word, then you will just add your word and you get inacceptable. Okay, acceptable, inacceptable. Achevé, inachevé. Okay, achevé. Inachevé. Admissible. Inadmissible. Admissible. Inadmissible. Animé. Inanimé. Animé. Inanimé. Attendu, inattendu, attendu, inattendu, imaginable, inimaginable, imaginable, inimaginable. Oubliable, inoubliable, oubliable, inoubliable, utile, inutile, utile, inutile. Le préfixe IR, and the good news is that it will be the last video for this chapter of prefix. Okay, so if you remember, when we're talking about prefix, actually we're talking about letters, like in that case IR, that you will add at the beginning of an existing word, and by adding these letters you will modify the meaning or the original meaning of the word. Okay, and in that case, when you will put this IR, and you will see that we're talking about words that will start with R, okay? But then you will modify the meaning, and the meaning will be privé de or sans, okay? Privé de or sans. So let's check three examples. And the first one is réel, okay? Réel, and then, as I said, you just add this IR, and then after that you put your réel again, and you will get irréel. Irréel, okay? Réel, and then irréel. Régulier, so as I said, remember, they start with R all the time. Régulier, And then exactly the same technique, IR, and after that you put it back, irrégulier, okay? Régulier, then irrégulier. And the last one, résistible, résistible, and exactly the same way, IR, and you put it back, irrésistible, irrésistible, so résistible, irrésistible. Le suffixe isé, I-S-E-R, okay, so after having doing some videos regarding les préfixes, now we'll try to see a little bit what we call les suffixes, okay, so les suffixes, actually we're talking about these letters that you can put or you can add at the end of existing words, and by adding these letters you will modify it or you will change the meaning, or in that case we will change adjectives into verbs. Okay, so that's the whole idea of this video, and here we'll only focus on the adjectives that will end with al. Okay, al. And then, well, as we saw, we will just add at the end of these adjectives this ISER just to make a verb. Okay, so let's see a few examples now. And the first one is banal. Okay, so here is the meaning in English. Okay, so if we want to make a verb out of this adjective, then we only need to, as I say, put this ISER at the end, and then you will get banaliser. Banaliser, okay? So, adjective banal, verb banaliser. Brutal, and then we will get brutaliser. Okay? Brutal, and then you just add this ISER at the end, and you'll get brutaliser. Central, centralisé, okay, exactly the same way, central, and then the verb, centralisé, égal, égalisé, égal, égalisé. Général, généralisé, général, généralisé, légal, légalisé, légal, légalisé. National, nationalisé, national, nationalisé. Le suffixe ement, ement, okay, and the idea is to, well, see how we can clearly come from a verb and to make from that verb a noun, okay, and so the idea is, we'll see that if your verb is ending with er, okay, so that's what we'll see in this video, but of course it doesn't, as usual when we learn French, it doesn't concern all the verbs ending with er, okay, but actually the verbs that we'll see in this lesson will work with that concept. So you will actually need to take away this er ending and you will replace it with the suffix, so this thing, E-M-E-N-T, okay, to get the noun. And you get to keep in mind that the noun must express the action, okay, because you can have many nouns or many substantives, as we say, that will express different things, okay, but in that case, when you're going from the verb to this substantive, so this noun, it must express the action, okay? So let's see a few examples now. The first one, so amuser, Okay, so you will have here the translation in English. Okay, so well, if we just respect the rule, so we take away this er, and then we will modify and we will put this suffix ent instead, and we will get this un amusement. Okay, so amuser, un amusement. Changer, un changement. Changer, un changement. Commencer, un commencement. Commencer, un commencement. Se comporter, un comportement. Se comporter, un comportement. Développer, un développement. Développer, un développement. Gouverner, un gouvernement. Gouverner, un gouvernement. Grouper, un groupement. Grouper, un groupement. Rassembler, un rassemblement. Rassembler, un rassemblement. Traiter, un traitement. Traiter, un traitement. Le suffixe ismant, okay? And the idea is to see how we could make nouns or substantives if we're starting from the verbs. Okay, so let's see. The idea is that we're talking here about the verbs that will belong to the second group of verbs, so ending in er. Okay, and well, the rule or the way to make them is that we'll take away this er, so the ending of the verb, and we'll replace it with the le suffix ismant, so ismant. Okay, so that's the rule. And then the only thing that we should keep in mind, because of course if we're talking about making substantives based on verbs, it's possible to have different type of substantives, but in that case the substantive, so the noun, must express the action. Okay, that's the only thing that you should keep in mind. Okay, so let's see a few examples now. The first one, élargir, and so you can see here the translation in English, un élargissement. Okay, so you can see that as we saw, you just need to take away this er from the verb and then you replace it with the issement, okay, and then you get the un élargissement. Okay, so élargir, un élargissement. Ralentir, un ralentissement. Ralentir, un ralentissement. Rajeunir, un rajeunissement. Rajeunir, un rajeunissement. Vieillir, un vieillissement. Vieillir, un vieillissement. Okay, so it will be the first. Here you can see the first video covering these E-O-N words that are the same in English and in French. Okay, and so the rule is that, of course, E-O-N, so you will have the same words in English and in French if the word exists in French, and that's the first thing. And then remember that in some cases, so will become E in French, so we will put the accent, and then in some cases, Z, so la lettre Z, will become la lettre S. Okay, all right, I didn't put the article, but then in most of the cases, they are feminine. Okay, so let's start now. Abdication, ablution, abnégation, abolition, abomination, abrogation, absorption, abstention, abstraction, accélération, accentuation, acceptation, accession, acclamation, accommodation, accréditation, accumulation, accusation, acidification, acquisition, action, activation, adaptation, addiction, addition, adhésion, administration, admiration, admission, adoption, adoration, adulation, aération, affectation, affection, affiliation, affirmation, agglomération, aggravation, agression, agitation, aliénation, alimentation, allégation, allocation, allocution, allusion, alphabétisation, altération, altercation. These topic identical words in English and in French, okay? And in that video, we'll cover the E, O, N, so we're talking about the endings here, words, okay? But then keep in mind that all the E, O, N words in English won't be the same in French, okay? So the first thing that you get to remember is that if it exists in French, then it will be the same, and normally the meaning will be the same. Keep in mind as well that in some cases we'll have some differences in the writing, okay? So could become A and then Z could become S, okay? But then let's see now. So it's the second part of the list. If you're interested by this thing, then remember that there was a previous video that covered 50 words. In that video we'll cover still 50 words, and then the, if I remember correctly, the total amount is 500, okay? So ambition, amélioration, amplification, amputation, animation, annexion, annotation, annulation, anticipation, apparition, appellation, application, appréciation, appréhension, approbation, appropriation, approximation, articulation, ascension, aspiration, assignation, assimilation, association, attention, atténuation, attestation, attraction, attribution, audition, augmentation, auscultation, aviation, bénédiction, bureaucratisation, calcification, calcination, calibration, canalisation, cannibalisation, capitalisation, célébration, cessation, cicatrisation, circulation, citation, civilisation, clarification, classification, coalition, cohabitation. Series of videos that we started earlier, and the topic is identical words in English and in French, and in that case we'll cover the words that will end with E-O-N. So the first rule that you've got to keep in mind is that if it exists in French, it will be the same, okay, but it's not all the time the case. Alright, and then the second thing that you should remember is that in some cases we'll write them a little bit differently, so you can see that in French will be A in some cases, and then Z here in some cases will become S. Okay, so let's see, and the list continues. Cohésion, collaboration, collation, collection, collision, collocation, collusion, colonisation, coloration, combustion, commémoration, commercialisation, commission, communication, communion, compassion, compensation, compétition, compilation, complication, composition, compréhension, compression, concentration, conception, conclusion, condition, confection, confédération, confession, configuration, confirmation, confrontation, confusion, connotation, consécration, conservation, considération, conspiration, consternation, construction, contagion, contamination, contemplation, contestation, continuation, contorsion, contraception, contraction, contradiction. Theme, identical words in English and in French, and we'll especially focus on this video and the previous and the following videos on the words that will end with E-O-N, okay? And then keep in mind that the first rule, it must exist in French. All E-O-N words in English, they don't exist in French, okay? So, well, that's the first thing. And then remember that in some cases, we'll write them a little bit differently. Okay, so that's the thing. And the list continues. Contravention. Contribution. Contusion, convention, conversation, conversion, conviction, convocation, coopération, coordination, coproduction, corrosion, corruption, création, crémation, criminalisation, sorry, it's a difficult one. So again, criminalisation, cultivation, cumulation, désactivation, déception, décision, déclaration, décolonisation, décomposition, décoration, déduction, définition, déformation, dégradation, dégustation, délation, délectation, délégation, délibération, démission, démobilisation, démocratisation, démodulation, démolition, démonétisation, démonstration, dénationalisation, dénaturalisation, dénigration, dénomination, dépigmentation, déportation, déposition, dépression, dérision. Identical words in English and French, and we'll only focus on the E-O-N, so the words that will end with E-O-N in English, and that will be the same in French, but then keep in mind that, of course, it must exist in French, because it's not the case for all the words in E-O-N. So be careful. That's the reason why I wanted to make this huge list, but then after that you'll know which one exists in French. And then remember that in some cases the word will a little bit change, so you've got the example here, will become A, and then Z will become S. Okay. Description, désignation, désolation, déstabilisation, destination, destruction, détection, détention, détérioration, détermination, détonation, dévaluation, dévastation, déviation, diction, diffusion, digestion, dilatation, dimension, diminution, direction, discrimination, discussion, disposition, disqualification, dissociation, distinction, distribution, diversification, diversion, divination, division, documentation, domiciliation, domination, donation, dotation, dramatisation, duplication, ébullition, éclosion, édification, édition, éducation, élaboration, électrocution, élévation, élimination, élocution, élucidation. Identical words in English and French, and we'll concentrate on the words ending with E-O-N, okay? And then remember that the main thing with this E-O-N words in English, that it must exist, of course, in French, because it's not the case for all the E-O-N words in English. And then, in some cases, we'll have some modifications in the writing in French, okay? So let's continue with 50 new words. émancipation, émission, émotion, épilation, équation, équitation, érosion, éruption, estimation, évacuation, évaluation, évaporation, évasion, évolution, exaltation, exaspération, exception, exclamation, exclusion, excursion, expansion, expatriation, expédition, expiration, explication, exploitation, exploration, explosion, exposition, expression, expulsion, extension, externalisation, extinction, extraction, extrapolation, fabrication, fascination, fédération, fiction, fixation, formation, formulation, fraction, fragmentation, frustration, fusion, généralisation, génération, glaciation.
Identical words in English and French, and we'll only focus in this video on the words in English that will end with E-O-N, because in many cases they will be exactly the same in French, but you should keep in mind that it's not all the time true. So first, well, the word must exist in French because it's not, you know, the case all the time. Okay, and then the second thing that you should keep in mind, in some cases, well, the writing of these words will change a little bit, okay? Gratification, gravitation, habitation, hésitation, hibernation, hospitalisation, humidification, humiliation, idéalisation, identification, illumination, illusion, illustration, imagination, imitation, immersion, immigration, immobilisation, immunisation, imperfection, implantation, implication, implosion, imposition, impression, improvisation, impulsion, inaction, inactivation, inattention, inauguration, incarnation, incinération, incitation, incompréhension, incorporation, incrustation, incubation, indécision, indexation, indication, indigestion, indignation, indiscrétion, indisposition, infection, inflation, information, infraction, infusion.
Identical words in English and French, and in this video we'll only focus still on the words in English that will end with E-O-N, and that will be the same in French. So in some cases persons tend to say that all the English words ending with E-O-N are exactly the same in French, And I've been working on that list quite much, and I can tell you that, unfortunately, that's not the truth. So the first thing that you should keep in mind, that it will be the same if it does exist in French, and it's not the case all the time. And then the second thing that you should keep in mind, that in some cases the writing of the words will change a little bit. Okay, let's start now. Injection, innovation, inscription, insertion, insolation, inspection, inspiration, installation, instauration, institution, instruction, intégration, intention, interception, interdiction, internationalisation, interpellation, interprétation, intervention, intimidation, intoxication, introduction, invasion, invention, investigation, invocation, irrigation, isolation, juxtaposition, légalisation, légion, législation, lésion, libéralisation, libération, limitation, location, locomotion, locution, lotion, malédiction, malformation, malnutrition, malversation, manifestation, manipulation, mention, migration, militarisation, million. And I just realized that I've been making a mistake here. It should be a 3 instead of 2, okay? Sorry, I won't make this video again only for these 2 little mistakes, okay? Identical words in English and French. And we'll especially focus on the words in English that will end with E-O-N, okay? Keep in mind that the first thing that you should remember is that it must exist in French, because all these E-O-N words in English won't exist in French. And then the second thing that you should keep in mind, in some cases the writing will change a little bit. Let's start. Mobilisation, modération, modernisation, modification, motivation, munition, mutation, mystification, narration, natation, nation, nationalisation, naturalisation, navigation, négation, nomination, notion, objection, obligation, observation, occasion, opération, opinion, opposition, optimisation, option, orchestration, organisation, orientation, pacification, palpitation, partition, passion, pension, perception, percussion, perfection, perforation, perfusion, permission, persécution, persuasion, perturbation, pétition, plantation, pollution, population, portion, position, possession. Identical words in English and French, and especially the words that will end with E-O-N. Keep in mind that not all the words in English that will end with E-O-N exist in French, so it must exist in French, of course, to be used in this language. And then the second thing that you should keep in mind, in some cases, the writing will change a little bit. Okay, so let's continue. Potion, précaution, précipitation, précision, prédiction, préméditation, prémonition, préoccupation, préparation, préposition, présentation, prévention, prévision, privatisation, procuration, production, profession, profusion, prohibition, projection, prolongation, promotion, proportion, proposition, propulsion, protection, protestation, provision, provocation, publication, pulsion, pulvérisation, punition, purification, qualification, ration, rationalisation, réaction, réactivation, réalisation, réclamation, récupération, rédaction, redécoration, redéfinition, rédemption, redirection, réduction, réévaluation, reformation. Identical words in English and French, and we were talking about the words in English that will end with E-O-N, okay? And that will be the same, but if they exist in French, because all the English words ending with E-O-N, well, they don't all exist in French. So that's the first thing that you should keep in mind. And then the second thing is that in some cases, we will write in French these words a little bit differently. So few cases like here, would become A, and then Z would become S, okay? So let's continue. Région, régression, relation, relaxation, religion, rénovation, réorientation, réparation, répartition, répétition, reproduction, répulsion, réputation, résolution, respiration, restitution, restauration, restriction, réunification, réunion, révélation, révision, révolution, rotation, salutation, sanction, saturation, sécession, section, séduction, sélection, sensation, séparation, signalisation, signification, simulation, situation, spécialisation, spécification, spéculation, stabilisation, station, stimulation, soumission, succession, suffocation, suggestion, supervision, suppression, synchronisation, télévision, tension, torsion, traction, tradition, transaction, transcription, transformation, transition, transpiration, transportation, union, urbanisation, utilisation, vaccination, valorisation, vaporisation, variation, végétation, version, vibration, victimisation, violation, vision, vocation,